Hello children, I know you are eagerly waiting for the digital class. You all are welcome to the class. In physics, we are learning different energies and their properties. The energies like sound energy, magnetic energy, electrical energy, heat energy, etc. By applying those properties, we are making our life simply and we are changing our lifestyles. If we come to the heat energy, we all know when we heat the objects, they are gaining heat and raising the temperature. And this temperature can transfer from one object to another object with the help of basic principle of thermometry. That is, the heat transfer takes place from high temperature body to a low temperature body. But if we go through the different properties of the heat, we have one of the most important property, that is specific heat. This specific heat is playing the important role in our lives. For example, sometimes we can observe in summer the heat inside the hut is somewhat less than the heat inside the buildings. And this is also the application of specific heat. Not only that, in utensils also we are applying the specific heat. By applying this specific heat, how can we change our lifestyle and in what factors we can apply all these things, we will find out. First, let us see the video and after that, what are the factors in that, what are the questions we are having in that. We will discuss at the end of this video. When we take the pieces of fruits like apple, guava, watermelon, etc. from the fridge, do they keep their coolness for same time? Have you ever observed the inside of samosa will be more hotter than outside of it? In these situations, watermelon piece keep its coolness for more time. Similarly, the inside of samosa will keep its hotness for more time. Do you know the reason for this? Let us find out the reason with some activities. The required material for the activity are beaker, test tubes, retort stands, thermometers, rubber corks, water, coconut oil, and spirit lamp. First, take equal masses of oil and water into separate boiling tubes. By fixing the thermometers in boiling tubes with rubber corks, keep them in a beaker with the help of retort stands. Now, pour the hot water into the beaker. The total arrangement looks like this. Now, observe the readings of two thermometers which are in water and oil in regular intervals of time. By observing the raising of temperatures in the thermometers, we can say that the rate of rise in temperature of oil is higher than that of rise in temperature of water. But finally, both will reach to same temperature. The rate of rise in temperature depends on the nature of the substance. To understand that nature, let us do some more activities. In the next activity, we will find the relation between mass and heat. The material required for this
beakers, thermometers, tripods, spirit lamps, water, rubber corks. Take 2 beakers of equal volume and take 100 grams of water in one beaker, 200 grams of water in another beaker. With the help of 2 similar spirit lamps, tripods, retort stands, thermometers, arrange the apparatus as shown in this figure. Now heat both beakers till the temperature of water in the 2 beakers rises up to 60 degrees Celsius. And observe the time required to raise the temperature of water to 60 degrees Celsius in each of the beaker. Here we can notice that 200 grams of water is taking more time when compared with 100 grams of water to raise to same temperature. So the amount of heat absorbed by a substance is directly proportional to its mass, that is, Q is proportional to M. Let us see one more activity to find the relation between heat and temperature. The material required for this: beaker, thermometer, water, spirit lamp, retort stand and tripod. Take some mass of water in beaker and with the help of stand place it on the tripod. With the help of spirit lamp, heat that water. Now observe the temperature changes in regular intervals while heating the water. Here we can notice that the temperature of water is rising with time, with constant supply of heat. So, for the same mass of substance, the change in temperature is proportional to amount of heat absorbed, that is, Q is proportional to delta T. Delta T is change in temperature. So the heat is directly proportional to mass of the substance, Q is proportional to M, and the heat is directly proportional to change in temperature, that is, Q is proportional to delta T. From this, Q is proportional to M delta T, and that is Q equal to MS delta T. Here, S is the specific heat of the substance. From this, S equal to Q by M delta T. So the specific heat of substance is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of unit mass of the substance by 1 unit. The units of specific heat. In CGS system, it is calorie per gram degree Celsius, and in SI system, it is joule per kg Kelvin. And the relation between these units, 1 calorie per gram degree Celsius equal to 420 joule per kg Kelvin. So the rate of rise or fall in temperature of a substance is depending on the specific heat of that substance. So now we can say the watermelon is keeping its coolness for more time, and inside of the samosa is keeping its hotness for more time is only due to their specific heats. The reason for the differences of specific heats of the substances can be explained by the internal energy of the system. which comprises of linear kinetic, rotational kinetic, vibrational and potential energies. When heat energy is supplied to the system, it will be shared by the molecules in the form of various energies. If maximum energy is utilized for linear kinetic energy, then the rise in temperature is high. For example, when heat is supplied to the water, that heat energy will be divided into different forms. Some of that energy will convert into linear kinetic energy, and due to that, the temperature of water will rise. Here is the table showing the specific heats of some substances. In this, some metals are there, some non-metals are there, water, kerosene, etc. By observing this table, the water is having more specific heat. That means the water requires more heat to raise the temperature. So, children, if the specific heat of material is high, it requires more heat to raise its temperature. So, the rate of rise in temperature for that material is less. And if the specific heat of material is low, it requires less heat to raise its temperature. So, the rate of rise in temperature is more for that material. And this is the reason why the rate of rise in temperature is different for water and oil in our first activity. Children, now we will see the daily life applications of specific heat. Generally, the cooking utensils are made of materials which are having low specific heat. To heat faster, nowadays, those are polished at the bottom with the materials like copper, aluminium, etc., which are having more specific heat. In thermometer, the body, generally glass, is having higher specific heat, and the tip is made of material with low specific heat, generally mercury or alcohol. In the construction of buildings or houses, the specific heat of material is playing important role. Wood, grass are having high specific heat. So wooden houses, huts will keep the inside cooler during summer compared with buildings. If we eat samosa within short time of their preparation, we will feel hot inside than outside. This is due to more specific heat of the curry inside. The handles of utensils are made of materials which have very high specific heat. They act as thermal insulators. Due to this, we can utilize the utensils easily. Due to more specific heat, the ocean water near the equator absorbs large amount of heat. This will be transported to ocean water towards the poles. This helps moderate the climate in different parts of the earth. The water in swimming pool remains cool for more time even in summer. This is because the water specific heat is high. The watermelon taken out from the refrigerator retains its coolness for longer time because it contains the large percentage of water whose specific heat is more. Key points of this lesson. Children, so far we discussed about the relation between heat and mass, the relation between heat and temperature, specific heat, reasons for difference in specific heat of different material, and daily life applications of specific heat. Children, now we will see some questions on this specific heat. What you understand about specific heat? What are the units of specific heat? Why the specific heat is different for different materials? Which utensil will be heated fast, copper or aluminium? What is the reason? How will you appreciate the role of specific heat of material in the construction of houses or buildings? What happens if specific heat of water will decrease suddenly? How the internal energy of the system is affecting the specific heat of substance? Why the water in swimming pool will remain cool for more time even in summer? Try to answer these questions.
Children, up to now in that video, we discussed about the very important property of heat, that is specific heat. What is its formula and on what factors it depends and what are the applications of that specific heat in our life. And now we will see one project in this. In your area, you collect the information of different houses. What are the material used for the construction of that house? Is there any difference in the temperatures in different seasons within that houses? You collect all this information and also collect the specific heat values of those material. Now, is there any relation between the specific heat of those materials and the heat inside that houses? If you collect all this information and prepare a table and analyze that, it will become a very good project. And one more thing is, in food items, we observe watermelon, samosa. You might come across different situations and different food items. If you find any of those things related to specific heat, you collect that information and list out that. And not only that, here we come across some questions in this video. You discuss all these with your friends, and if you are not getting that information, you have to take that from your teacher. I hope you all understood this specific heat, and with that, I am taking leave. Namaste.